Hey guys, it's Dylan, and in this video I'm going to be reviewing the Autumn Gold Tour Pass, Season 29. This is an interesting Tour Pass, to be honest. It is our first four hard Tour Pass that we've had in quite a while. I'm not exactly sure how many seasons, but we've been pretty deprived of hards. So this feels like a good change of pace, honestly. I'm glad they've brought back the four hard, four normal, one extreme sort of Tour Pass. The song selection, I'm also not very mad about. There's quite a few good ones in here. There's also some hit or misses, but yeah, let's go ahead and get into the gameplay. Actually, no, pause. Before we do the gameplay, let's go ahead and look at the cosmetics. So yeah, if we come down here, here is the autumn banners. We have just kind of a basic leaf pattern. We have a more detailed leaf one, which I think is actually pretty clean. Then we also have this kind of like, I don't know, it almost looks like burnt leaves on the side, but it's a very pretty banner. And then we have the level 30 banner, which honestly, I really like this one. I think this one's pretty clean. I think I would definitely rock this one over the last one, even though the last one is pretty cool. I think this one has just sort of a stylistic design to it that I like, and it goes well with the blue bee. And I like any banner that pairs with one of the colored bees, to be honest. And then the emote, which is going to be the marijuana leaf. No, I'm kidding. It's a leaf. But if you freeze it on green, it looks suspiciously like something else. but that's besides the point. I guess we can also look at the troll stuff, because that is going on right now. I've got the two troll banners there. I'm not going to rock any of those, because I do not like trolls. And most people find the trolls pretty awful. That seems to be the general consensus here. And then here are the troll avatars. Again, I'm not going to rock any of those. I don't particularly like trolls myself, but you do you. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into the gameplay segment. We have, are you going to go my way? Are you going to go my way? Question mark. By Lenny Kravitz. This song I had never heard before, but oh my gosh, I took the time to listen to it, and wow, it's a really good song. So I'm excited. Interesting. Nice, man. Really good chart. Really, really good chart. And it might just be because I'm biased against the song, you know, but or biased for the song. But I really like that chart. That was a really good standard for hard. I'm not mad at it. Yeah, that was really good. And I liked that they didn't really underchart with the guitar at all. They kind of just let loose there. That felt really clean. All right. Let's, Yeah, and so I'm gonna have a lot of things to collect here in a sec. Once I get my case slots full, I'm probably going to have to claim unlimited play, unfortunately. But next up, we have the Season Extreme Avalon. We have the Return of Chaos Bay. So, hopefully it's as good as 2 billion. We'll see here, though. I've never heard this one. I've never heard any. I don't really listen to Chaos Bay, so I wouldn't know. Nice undercharted. This is really starting slow, isn't it? This is awful. Whoa. That's awful. Do I hate that? Okay, I feel like I got lucky there, but I really dislike that. So, let's see here, it was very boring. Beginning was very slow. The rhythms in it are just very awkward. I don't know, the jacks, I don't dislike them, but I don't love them. And the part with the jacks next to the hold notes was really awkward. I'm surprised I didn't botch one of those up. Honestly, that was like the hardest part there. It was that fucking chorus. Really weird. I'm kind of mixed on this one. I don't even think I'm mixed. I just don't like it. Ooh, the hat's in the shop? Okay, we might be grabbing that. I might be grabbing that in the video. Next up is Green Green Grass by George Ezra. I've never heard this before. Apparently it was pretty popular. Kind of sounds a bit annoying to me, but hey, maybe it has some decent parts to it, so let's give it a chance. See, if it's got good verses, I can get behind it. Thank you. Okay, so good normal chart. Good normal chart. It's probably got a lot of notes, I would expect here. Let's see. 345, that's a decent amount for a normal. Still kind of mixed on the song. It felt very repetitive. And that could just be me, though. But, I feel like, after hearing the song a certain amount of times, it just gets very, very repetitive. That's okay, I suppose. I'll let it slide. It had a good chart. I'll give that to it. So I wasn't completely annoyed. Next up we have It Must Be Love by Madness. And I gotta admit, the album cover here has got me hooked. That is such a goofy album cover. I love it. Let's do this. Mr. Bean? This all sounds very familiar. What a weird normal. I mean, I'll be honest, that one shocked me with the sort of some of the rhythms there. There was a lot of weird rhythms going on. I don't hate the song. It's a very slow song, though. But honestly, you know, despite it not having a ton of notes, it still delivered a pretty interesting normal chart that's pretty unique from the rest. Like, I'd say a lot of parts in that were pretty easily identifiable to this song, which is pretty cool. We don't see that a lot with the lower note count normals. Next up we have Pop by NSYNC. This song is just, it slaps so hard. It slaps so hard. It makes you want to get up and just start dancing. It's such a good song. So I'm really excited for this one. And like, I like NSYNC. And I like Backstreet Boys. So, this stuff is good. Beatstar. That was awesome. That was awesome. I mean, there's just no other words to put it. What a well-structured hard song. Whoever made this chart needs a raise. Face it, if you're listening, make sure that whoever made this chart is making more charts than the rest, because that was a really well-structured chart. Everything stayed the same and consistent throughout the whole thing. It was just a good experience. No words. I mean, yes words. That was awesome. That was amazing. Thank you. Decent hearts are all I asked for, and that's what we get. Next up, we have Rock and Roll All Night by Kiss. A Kiss song. How awesome is that? And a classic one. You know, this is a classic right here. Bet it drifts like a son of a bitch, though. Yeah, a little bit. Ain't as bad as Sliver. That one drifted a lot. Oh, there's the cursed undercharting that we all love. Stage 3 and we're undercharting. Nice. Oh, we're still undercharting. Stage 4 and we're still undercharting. Nice. There we go. I had to wait till final stage for that one. Nice. I think that song actually does play out pretty well as a normal. The drift really wasn't even noticeable, so yeah, that was just a really good one. And 318 notes, that was more than I thought I was going to have, so hell yeah, we'll take that. Awesome. Alright, next up we have Tragedy Humanity, an EDM song. I think this might be the small artist song of the season. For War Machine, I have no clue. I don't know how popular this song is. I know it's an EDM song that was hard to find on YouTube, so. Just listening to it, I'm surprised it didn't get an extreme deluxe. Sounds like you could do like straight 16th in that background. Kind of slaps though, I'm not gonna lie. Not sure if it's something I would listen to in my free time, but like, it's just a good song in general. Gives off like Geometry Dash songs, you know. I can make a pretty good level to this song. Oh, you asshole. God damn. longest fucking staircase in history. Whoa, that one was coming. Dude, I got intense at the end. What the heck? I started panicking. I'm like, oh my god, dude, these swipes are kind of going crazy on the doubles. Wow, okay. How many notes is that? 470 only? Wow. I mean, heck, for 470 notes, you're getting your bang for your buck on that one. Yeah. That one was just very satisfying. The song is very clicky, so it feels very good to kind of snap your notes into place there. I don't know. It was just a very, very satisfying experience. I was not... The hard songs this season have not disappointed. The normals have been a little bit lackluster, but we're coming up on a really good one. I mean, everyone's heard this song. An absolute banger classic. And it looks like this is the remake or something? 2010 or 20-something? I don't know. But this song's awesome. You can't help but smile when you hear this song. This song Swing, right? I'm actually not sure. It sounds Swing. Some parts of it do. Hey! It's very empty. Maybe it isn't Swing. Maybe I'm tripping. Maybe it isn't Swing then. Maybe it isn't Swing. If it is, they fucked up. But if it's not, which it kind of seems like it might not be, but it's still. I mean, I had a grin on my face. I love. Yeah, okay, it is the 2010 remaster. Okay, cool. But I love, every time they add a recognizable song like this to the game, it just feels like you're making the library more complete. So I can appreciate that, you know? Oh, that's good, though. That's good. Yeah, the chart played pretty well. Last up, we have War Machine. This is another EDM song. Oh, watch an ad. I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. We're live. This song sounds intimidating yet underwhelming, so we'll see how this goes. Sounds like it might have an interesting deluxe though, especially since they went with Extreme. Whoa, that was a really delayed swipe. I don't know what happened there. That threw me off. Pretty charted for stages too. Wow. Interesting. This might have a lot of notes. Shit. Wasn't expecting this. Okay, I wasn't expecting all this shit. Oh my gosh, give me a second, guys. Oh, I apologize, guys. That's my bad. That was a very unexpected ending. That turned up the heat really quickly. That's pretty difficult. I got double fucked on that one. Damn, 592 notes. Okay. Well, shiver me shitless. That's pretty crazy. Wow. What a way to end off the season. Yeah, guys. Honestly, this season I'm thinking pretty positively on. Apart from the extreme, which is a bit of a disappointment, the hard charts and hard songs are just really carrying the season. The normals were decent too, but the hards were really strong. And I wonder why. It's our first four hard season in a while. So, yeah, I mean, it makes sense. I can't decide if I want to do box openings at the end of this video. I think you guys would appreciate that. So I'll go ahead and cut to when I have a couple boxes open here. Alright, here's our first case. I think this choice is pretty obvious, but I'm gonna go ahead and take Pop, of course. Absolute banger. But I've still got rewards to claim for both this and the Trolls event, so I'll see you when I get another box. Didn't realize I was gonna get this many cards, but the Trolls event straight up got me to another box. And to be honest, the only one that stands out here is, of course, the Lenny Kravitz banger. We're gonna take that one, of course. But I think I'm actually going to go ahead and buy this pack right here. So I will go ahead and purchase that, and we'll open up those. Alright, so here I think Tragedy Humanity is probably the standout. So let's go ahead and grab that one. And come on, give me something good. Alright, and you give me an extreme. I will definitely be taking War Machine. Alright guys, well, that's pretty much it. You've got a couple of videos here to be expecting in the future, but I hope you guys enjoyed the Tour Pass review. Personally, I think this one was pretty good. Maybe not as good as the Monster Cat Tour Pass, but I do think this one is still strong in terms of some of the previous Tour Passes we've had. So yeah, I will see you guys in the next video.